Any couple, we can take a couple questions if anybody wants to toss them out. Go ahead, Jane.
Okay, I was reading the story about your sit down in labor notes, May 12th. We asked them to write about how did you do the sit down so everybody else could know. And I thought they would write about, oh, this is how we had the cooking, this is how we had the guards on the doors. You don't start hearing about that until halfway through the story. Half of the story is all the things they did before that.
Two things. First, we wasn't a corrupt union before. It make us fight against that union. And the other thing is we always fight with the immigrants' community allies. La pregunta que me hizo ella es de que, ¿cómo es de que nosotros logramos organizarnos? Y lo que yo le contesto es de que hay dos cosas. Que teníamos una unión corrupta, que siempre lo que quería el patrón nos daba, la unión siempre nos pisoteaba la unión. Y la segunda es de que siempre hemos trabajado con nuestros aliados, que son en apoyo a los emigrantes.
Gracias.
Given the premier event that has been organized in large part by Jobs and Justice and the labor community, Workers' Rights Coalition in Chicago play an absolutely critical role. We had worked for many years to nurture that relationship and, in fact, to help build that coalition. We've been primary in it for many years. Armando and the leaders and members of his local carry the UE banner and the giant immigrants' rights marches that have taken place in Chicago, and probably so. We built very important alliances there that came into play in this fight. His first reference was to their having left the gangster union. Step one here was democratic unionism. They had to get out of a corrupt, do-nothing, dues collection racket and join a real union, a rank and file union. They did that. Yeah.
From this, that's when we knew that what you all were doing out in the streets was making a hell of a lot of difference.